Welcome back. In previous video we discussed on the phrasal verbs as well as its and objects, direct, indirect, and also we discussed on verbs called transitive and intransitive verbs. Transitive verb is known as who take an object to make meaningful sentence, and those verbs are not taking or not allowed to take an object such as cry and sleep. These verbs are not allowed to take an object for complete meaning. And also die transitive verbs we have seen, that is it takes two objects in a similar sentence. One is an indirect and second one is a direct object. Let us continue. In English, most direct objects can also be expressed as prepositional phrases beginning with two or four. So the sentence can also be expressed as following: the waiter handed the bill to me. The waiter handed the bill to me. Rahel gave a book to Mary. In English, most indirect objects can also be expressed prepositional phrases. Prepositional phrase here including two and four. We have seen the example: the waiter handed the bill to me. Rahel gave a book to Mary. It may be noted here, however, the following sentence is not grammatical sentence. Let's see. Krishna asked if he could go out to play to his mother. Krishna asked if he could go out to play to his mother. Another way to identify an indirect object is to see which of the two objects can be dropped without making the sentence ungrammatical. Indirect objects are usually the recipients or receivers of an action, and if they are dropped in a sentence, we assume it to be implied. So we can say sentence. Let us see. The waiter handed the bill. Rahel gave a book. Krishna asked if he could go out to play. In this all sentences, we found even though the indirect objects are dropped, it is assumed to be there. So interpreter sentence K4, handed to someone as give to someone, and ask someone to remember that whatever be kind of verb, only nouns, noun phrases and noun clauses can act as the subject, direct object or the indirect object of a clause. This is only used in the noun clause or noun phrase. Now we are going to move another most important part of the clause. Let us see parts of clauses. In previous lecture we have discussed on objects of the phrase or clause. Now let us see complements and adverbials. You will recollect that we had earlier said that in many ways the verb determines the presence of the other elements, phrases or clauses in sentences. We can say that because the verb requires someone to do the action, we have subjects, and whatever verbs require that the action is to be carried out on someone or something, we have objects. However, we also know the most sentences do not just contain the subject and the objects, but also many other items which tell us about the manner, time, reason or place of the action. In as far as they are not compulsorily required to make a sentence grammatical, these may or may not be used in a sentence. Thus, we have two kinds of elements that are present in a sentence. Some elements that come in a sentence are compulsorily required. That is, if we drop them, the sentence becomes ungrammatical. Subjects and objects, such entities are compulsory in sentences. Due to that, the sentence will be meaningful. There are also certain other elements in a sentence like the expression specifying time, reason, etc., which can be easily dropped without affecting the grammatically of the sentence. Thus, we could take our sentence from the previous section and extend them as follows. The waiter handed me the bill with a smile. Rahel gave Mary a book in the bus to read. Krishna asked his mother if he could go out to play yesterday. These underlined words are talking about more. That is known as complementary. What supposed to do the underlined expressions serve in these sentences? We can see that with a smile answer the questions. How specify the manner of action? Similarly, in the bus, answer the question where and specify the place of the action. To read answers why and specify the reason for the action, and yesterday answers when the specifies the time and time of the action, and all the these sentences would still be grammatical if we were not to use any of these underlined expression at all, which is not the case with the other elements. While it is possible to say Rahel gave Mary a book without optional elements, it is ungrammatical to say Rahel gave Mary without a direct object. Such compulsory elements of clause are known as complements in linguistics analysis, and the optional elements are known as adverbials or sometimes as adjuncts. I repeat, so while it is possible to say Rahel gave Mary a book, Rahel gave Mary a book without the optional elements, it is ungrammatical to say Rahel gave Mary without the direct object. Such compulsory elements of clause are known as complements in linguistics analysis, and the optional elements are known as adverbials or sometimes adjuncts. You should not confuse the term adverbial with the part of speech adverb, though both of them are optional elements and are used to single manner, time, reason, place, etc. However, there is a crucial difference. While adverbs are single word entities like slowly, never, fast, etc., adverbials can be of different syntactic types. If you look at the example sentences above, you will notice that with a smile and in the bus are prepositional phrase. To read is a clause subject, and yesterday is an adverb phrase. Adverbials look similar in their name to adverbs because of their function in a sentence. As grammatical categories, they are not the same. Adverbs are just one type of adverbials. Adverbials are of many other types as well. The concept of complements is not restricted to only subject and object. However, it always stands for compulsory elements of a sentence. Some likes, verbs like seem, appear, etc., always require a compulsory element after them. These compulsory elements are not recognized as objects, but as the complements of sentence, strictly complements of the subjects. They are demonstrated in examples below. He seems happy. Aisha is in a bad mood. Jack is mathematics teacher. I repeat, he seems happy. Aisha is in a bad mood. Jack is a mathematics teacher. In these sentences, happy, adjective and adjective phrase. In a bad mood, prepositional. In a bad mood, prepositional phrase. And a mathematics teacher is noun phrase. Are all compulsory elements but not the objects. They cannot be dropped. They tell us more about the subject and therefore also called the subject complements. English also has object complements with verbs like make, regard, etc., as can be seen in following examples. English also has object elements with verbs like make, regard, etc. Let's see. They made Dhoni the the captain. They regard the protests as a nuisance. They regard the protests as nuisance. The underlying expression, the captain, and as a nuisance, cannot be dropped without making the sentence ungrammatical. They made Dhoni. What? The captain. Since they give us more information about the objects, they are known as object complements. While Dhoni and protest are the object of the verb, the captain and as a nuisance, not object of the complements. This is all about the object of complement. We stop here. Remaining part we will see in next video.